Today, Lambeau Field will be pumped up for two of the NFC's best. Despite playing below expectations, both the Vikings and the Packers are ready to take aim and fire. Can the leader of the pack defuse the Vikings, or will Minnesota's high-octane offense set its sights and bomb away? Legendary Lambeau Field. There's no place like it. Antonio Freeman said yesterday, it's like playing in a place with electricity in a box. I'm Pat Summerall here with John Madden. The Vikings are in town today. Minnesota threw for 442 yards last year against the Packers, the most ever against a Green Bay team. There are people who say this year, John, that Ray Sherman, the new offensive coordinator, is too conservative. What do you say?
Now, I think they have been a little too conservative in their first couple of games. They haven't gotten their running game going. But as I look at them on film, I just think it's consistency. I mean, they'll move the ball, then they'll have a penalty. Move the ball, then they'll have a fumble. They get inside the 20, they have a field goal block. I think that they just have to get their consistency back. Then on defense, one thing, they have to go after Brett Favre. We talked to him last night. They said they're going to come after him straight up the middle because the key to the Packer offense always has been and will be Brett Favre.
And Brett Favre has a bad thumb. What about the condition of that, and how will that affect the Green Bay offense?
Well, you know, last week when we were watching film, I felt that against Detroit that it really did affect Brett Favre. I watched him in practice this week, and he's fine. He has all his guns. He has everything going. But the big story here is going to be defense, how their defense does about the Minnesota Vikings. Remember, last year, the Vikings, with their passing game, just lit them up. As a result, the Packers went out, and their first three draft choices were defensive backs. And we're going to find out very shortly how those guys are going to do.
And we'll be right back at Lambeau Field.
Let's launch it, Slim.
We talked about this all week. We got to stick with the game plan. We got to run the ball.
James says the max protect. Out right, box right, hound right, near right. Sit, 989.
Who's James?
Use your Visa card and you could win a once-in-a-lifetime NFL fantasy. Play flag football with the pros. Go to the Pro Bowl in Hawaii. Be in a Super Bowl halftime show. Or roam the sidelines before a real game. Visa, it's everywhere NFL fans want to be.
We gotta stop 36. This is our season here, boys. Come on, guys, now
we're gonna eat you up, big man. I'm gonna eat you up. Hurt, hurt!
Cyberbutt.
Yeah,
and his ball-hawking, tightrope-walking, jaw-dropping Jumbotron Hawks.
Yeah.
Madden NFL 2000 EA Sports. It's in the game.
It's time for the E-Trade Return of the Week, brought to you by America's number one online broker. On Sunday, the 49ers' hopes for victory hung by a thread. That is, until a fourth-quarter interception stole the show.
Good evening.
I know, license and registration.
Kirk Brewer. I've been wanting to talk to you.
Me?
You're the fund manager for my large cap fund.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
So I noticed you made the top 10.
Yeah. Yeah.
But not the top 5. Let's put the clubs away and get back to the office.
It's time for the E-Trade Mutual Fund Center. Instant scrutiny of over 4,700 funds.
The following presentation of the National Football League.
The The NFC Central match between the Vikings and the Packers at Lambeau Field in Green Bay. It's very windy, John, and I think that's going to have some sort of an effect before we're through.
Well, especially on the kicking game. You know, we saw that in the pregame warm-up. There was no such thing as a punter punting a spiral. They were all punting wobblers. But I tell you, it's going to be windy and it's going to be noisy. This crowd is a great football crowd.
Got that Green Bay offense. Led by Brett Favre, his 112th consecutive start, and that's remarkable. Verba, Wall, Winters, Rivera, and Dotson. Dotson playing very well. Dorsey Levens, William Henderson, the two runners, Schrader, Freeman, and Davis, the three receivers. The front four, Dwayne Clements, John Randall, Williams, and John Burrow. Dwayne Rudd, Ed McDaniel in the middle, and Corey Miller. And the secondary, Hitchcock and Ramos McDonald, the corners, Orlando Thomas and Robert Griffith, who makes a bomb tackle. The two safeties. Second and eight. Favre again drops. Minnesota blitz, and Favre started to turn out of the pocket and turned right into Dwayne Clemens.
And Clemens was up the field on Ross Verba. Verba was blocking him. And as you say, as Favre spins out there, he's going to spin right in here. You're going to see him. Clemens is going to come up the field. Favre goes here. When he gets to get out of the rush, they want to pressure him, as we said, up the middle, get him out of the pocket, then have those ends come up the field. Now when he scrambles and goes like that, they want a defensive end standing right there, just like, and that's the way the Vikings are playing their defense. Pressure up the middle, defensive end stay outside.
Favre drops again, fires outside, first down, Schrader. A strike from Favre. Well, we mentioned before he was injured, and look at that.
Well, you look at the thing, and this, I guess, is just from artificial turf here. I mean, the hand looked ugly, but where the problem is right here in the thumb. And you can see, well, if you compare it to the other thumb, like he showed us yesterday, it is swollen. Need a pass rusher, and they're going to use him this whole game in that situation.
Got to agree.
John Randall at the other defensive end.
Dolman got away from Verba. Hard scramble forward, throws up the field, it's batted away, deflected.
I think he hit Dwayne Rudd, the linebacker, right in the face with it.
Yes, he did. He's to the six-yard line where it was first touched by the Packers. First and 10 at their own six for Minnesota. Randall Cunningham. Robert Smith. Led by Randall McDaniel. Randall Cunningham, I'm sorry. 6-1 record as a starter. In front of him, a veteran offensive line. Stussy, McDaniel, Christie, Dixon, and Stringer. Robert Smith, run of the winners. Randy Moss, Chris Carter, Jake Rudolph. Near a first down. Have a look at Green Bay's defensive unit. The front four, Bonnie Holiday, Gilbert Brown, Billy Lyons starting in place of Santana, Dotson, and Booker. Brian Williams, Harris, and Koontz, the three linebackers. And in the secondary, Tyrone Williams, Sharper, Leroy Butler, and Mike McClure
on Randy Moss.
Jude Waddy checks into the defense. Cunningham quickly to Carter. First down and more with some room. Tyrone Williams finally wrestled him down. An assist. Leroy Horde is the deep back. Cunningham throws quickly in that slot. This is to Jake Reed, and he'll have another first down deep in Packer territory. Brian Williams.
You'll see what they did is they put Randy Moss on the other side, and that time they put Randy Moss and Chris Carter on the other side. Jake Reed on this side.
Vikings. Cunningham looks. Caught by Carter. Carter inside the 10 where it'll be first and goal, Minnesota. Well, Leroy Butler.
You know, I was just saying they've gone to work over there on Tyrone Williams. They talk about all the rookies. Let's go for a little power here.
Leroy Horde, the lone setback. Cunningham. Incomplete. Intended for Carter. There's the flag. He had his hand up.
I'm going to call that one on.
Johnny Greer.
Number 42, defense in the end zone. The ball will be placed at the one-yard line. First down.
You know, a good center will get you a little on that, too. You know, he'll move the ball up a little for you.
the Vikings have a good one. Cunningham for the scrambling, and Cunningham is taken down at the four and knocked back to about the six. He didn't get in either.
And these are the types of things that happen to the Minnesota Vikings this year. It's just the consistency. They get down there, Hoyt doesn't get in. They try and run a quarterback sneak, and Cunningham didn't have any place to go. And George Kuntz there, he has a little extracurricular activity. But,
with Todd Stussy.
But that was very, very good goal line defense.
The flag was a long time before it was dropped.
Personal foul, unnecessary roughness. Number 53, the defense. You have a first down.
George just quit right there. Yeah. It would have been okay.
I don't know how they called a penalty against him.
I don't know that they saw what Todd Stussy did.
I don't think they did. Here's Horde again. And Leroy Horde scored.
And a great block by Todd Stussy.
Yep.
I mean, that was Leroy Horde ran right in there. Again, this is good goal line blocking this time.
So the Vikings, with some help, take the 7-0 lead.
Teaching aids on the sideline that they do between series.
Barb back to throw. Has a man up the middle. He's got a first down. It's Antonio Freeman. He knows how to find the open spots. And they lost a guy. He's the right defensive end. 11. Crosses the 40, hit by Orlando Thomas.
Now taking Mark Shamura's place is Tyrone Davis. The safety is back off when he's going to help deep. And he's going to get up there later on the run.
Far. Screen pass. 11. Got two blockers in front. Out of bounds at the Minnesota 43. Orlando Thomas knocked him out of bounds.
He's not going to stop running because you know that he doesn't stop.
Far. To the 15, the 10, and out of bounds at about the Minnesota 4 by Hitchcock. Making 7, the Packers, nothing. Fox NFL Sunday from Lambeau Field will continue after these messages.
I can't believe you tore a stunt like that. What were you thinking?
You weren't thinking, were you?
I don't think so. You think you're different?
You think you're special?
No, no, I don't.
Get that camera out of here.
Did we go over there?
We did.
You want to coach this team?
I didn't know it was the last one. He's so sensitive.
He's a mind too.
Think 360 degrees of free-range motion and complete weightlessness won't affect your ability to shoot straight? Introducing Omega Boost, a stomach-turning, gravity-defying shooting game.
Are you all right, officer?
Yeah, good.
John Elway had just engineered his 47th game-saving drive. A reporter asked him why he had so many come-from-behind victories. Elway thought about it, smiled, and said, I guess because we were always behind.
Expect more from an original. Original Coors. Brewed a mile high.
My beer? Coors. An original Coors.
Qualifications?
Oh, well, I was the first pick in the NFL draft.
Can you drive a forklift?
Play the Gatorade Win It Instantly game, and you could win a year's supply of Gatorade delivered by either Michael Jordan, Peyton Manning, Mia Hamm, or Marc Martin. Or a ton of other prizes, like your own Gatorade vending machine. Just look under the cap.
Peyton, you gotta win in Phoenix.
The Simpsons in Hollywood.
They're making a movie. Robert Downey Jr. is shooting it out with the police.
I don't see any cameras.
On the season premiere tonight at 8, 7 Central on Fox.
Second and goal. 11. Touchdown. Flag on the play. A flag on the play.
It's going to be holding against the Packers, and that's why you hear the crowd started to cheer, cheer, and then they could see that penalty, and it'll be holding against the Packers.
Holding. 52, offense.
Frank Winters.
Still second down.
anxiously looking on. Henderson in motion. To Levin at the 10, where he's lapped up by Dwayne Rudd. And the Packers are going to have to settle for a field goal. Ryan Longwell is perfect this year so far. To put the Packers on the board, and he does. And so it's 7-3 in the second quarter at Lambeau Field, a 29-yarder. Over Green Bay, second and 7 at their own 28. Smith, Robert Smith. First down, Vikings. Darren Sharper had to make the tackle.
I tell you, he gets some good blocks over there from his left side from Randall McDaniel and Todd Stussy. I mean, move your feet, stay low, and stay with the block.
First and 10. Cunningham. Sack. The pressure got him. Jay Green covered by the rookie Antoine Edwards. Cunningham looking. And complete. Intended for Jake Reed, who was either pushed down or fell down. Throwing down for Brett Favre. Fakes to Levin, steps up, and throws. Schrader. First down.
That was a reach block. You technically call a reach block, and Frank physically reached.
Favre drops. Tosses to Levin's wide open, a lot of room, a first down in Minnesota territory.
Yeah, we were talking about who's going to take the place of Mark Chimura, you know, and you're covering him. You can't run as fast as he can. Grab a little cloth.
Henderson on second and 10, an unexpected gallop by William Henderson.
Dorsey Levin's and all those things. Boom, there goes old William Henderson.
Third and 1. You see that yellow line as Levin's is knocked backwards. Regains his balance and loses yardage after all that.
What's this crowd now get into this?
And here's Cunningham. Pass is picked off. That's Antoine Edwards. And Edwards heads for the end zone. Touchdown. The Packers go ahead. That'll wake up the Lambeau crowd.
Impressive guy.
That's what he'll remember. If they could reverse, going to throw a screen, and they got it set pretty good. Leroy Hard upended out at about the 38-yard line. George Koontz came over to make the hit.
And downfield.
Held to receiver downfield. Number 64, offense.
Randall McDaniel. It's called for the violation. They'll back it up.
And it wandered up and then wandered down, but he was downfield. That was just poor concentration.
First and 15. The handoff is to Robert Smith. And he is taken down by Bonnie Holiday for a loss.
Well, you know, to a team and to players are just devastating.
That's a key injury. Here's Cunningham back to throw again and going deep. And out of bounds and flags everywhere. Jake Reed, the intended receiver.
5 yards.
And they really got tangled up. And
pass interference, number 24, defense, first down.
You're going to see Antoine Edwards is right here. And the first 5 yards you can bump, but he's doing what they call a bail technique. He's bailing out of the zone. Then he's looking back, and he started to come under. He was looking at Randall Cunningham.
To me, very good technique. Here's Robert Smith again. And he'll knock down the ball, comes loose. The official said he was down.
Grab him and just try and put him on the ground and do those kinds
of
things.
He's not going to beat you lying down. Here's Smith again. And he gets a Viking first down.
Pulling centers. He never played.
There aren't many can do it. Here's Smith again. Mo Williams, I'm sorry, not Smith. Smith gets a believer.
McDaniel, though?
Yes.
He just straightened him up and put him right in the backfield.
Nothing doing again. That's not a first down.
And again, Gilbert, and again, Randall McDaniel doesn't get any movement there. I would think that, you know, again, not second guessing, but I guess I am, but you would have better, you know, success with the pass or the bounce out or the outside run.
He's close, but I don't know if he got it or not.
Well, again, it's the ball. It's where the football is. And the football, like, it has to get over the plane on the goal line. It has to get over an imaginable plane.
Imaginary. Jake Reed got the single coverage from Tyrone Williams, and Cunningham whipped it out. Two-minute warning. Three touchdown. They broke all kind of records. Second and three. Cunningham fades, fell down. Getting away from the center, stayed down, got up, and fell down again.
And I'm back to you, Pat and John.
All right. That must be like bend but don't break. Bleed but don't die. Here's Cunningham.
Gone.
Jake Reed, open. Makes the catch at the Packer 25. Hooked up in the middle of that zone. Pass caught in the slot by Andrew Glover. The big tight end.
You know, the Packers are playing a lot of a dime defense.
A minute left in the first half. Cunningham drops and throws. Incomplete. Intended for Jake Reed. Barry Anderson. He's two out of six this year. Last year he was perfect until the championship game. This one ties it. 10-10.
You know, Denny Green knows, and they all talk about how this is going to be a fight and a war. You know, you talk to both coaches, and the first thing, you know, what's this game going to be like? Oh, anytime we come here, it's a fight, it's a war, it's this. And this first half has really been all of that. That was the one that got big old Joe Phillips to jump offside.
Barr drops again. Look out. From behind, it's Chris Dolman. Just out of retirement.
That's injuries.
After today already, Denver and Atlanta both 0-3. They're in the Super Bowl last year.
That you get for going to the Super Bowl. We teach you.
Go to that Super Bowl.
Here's Favre. And Favre is down. From the other side by Dwayne Clemens. So that's the end of the first half. With the score Minnesota 10, Green Bay 10, halftime.
You know, Kenny and I never compare statistics.
Or Super Bowls.
That way we can drink our Miller Lights without arguing. Right, Mr. Fewer career touchdown passes than me?
Right, Mr. Never been to the big one.
We only talk about why Miller Lite tastes great.
It's the choice hops.
No, Snake. Miller Lite tastes great because it's smooth. But let's not fight.
Yeah, you're right. Let's be friends.
Table ready for Mr. I don't have as many passing yards as Dan Fouts.
Hey, that's you.
Miller Lite. Taste the true Pilsner.
You guys are in here again? I can't believe this! You're always in here nursing your injuries. I have never seen such a group of cream puffs in my life. This is football! I need guys that can play!
Man, I thought he'd never leave.
With a great taste that won't fill you up and never let you down, make it a Bud Light.
Hot dog, anyone?
What's up, Glow Boy? You need to make a call.
Oh, Steve, look,
What's up?
You don't need any change. Just dial 1-800-COLLECT.
Help me, love.
Yeah, 1-800-COLLECT. You can save a buck or two. Go ahead, try it. Don't mention it. Just tell all your buddies. Tourists.
1-800-COLLECT. Save a buck or two.
We have a stand-up in progress at 211 Hazelwood.
He's in there.
Sir, drop the chalupa. Put it down and back away.
Sir, don't be silly. Drop the chalupa.
I said, drop the chalupa.
Put it down, man.
Yeah, drop the chalupa.
Get your hands on the new chalupa. With a shell so crispy, flaky, chewy, tasty, you'll wonder why we put stuff in it at all. Just 99 cents, only at Taco Bell.
Better get some backup.
Roger.
Halftime at Lambeau Field is just about over. Ties score Minnesota 10, Green Bay 10. And it's been pretty much what you would expect from NFC Central Division rivalry. Any strange things happen as far as you're concerned?
Yeah, to me, it's still been a sparring match. The fight hasn't started yet. Both teams really haven't opened up. They've been a little cautious. They've done some things that, they would like to have back. They've had, some stupid penalties and some of those things. I'm sure as a coach, you go in there and you say, look, okay, we have to go out there and start off to score 0-0 and start the game and just play our football, because I don't feel that the Minnesota Vikings have played Viking football, nor do I feel in this first half that the Packers have played Packer football.
Stats we were talking about. Look at those penalties down at the bottom you were talking about.
Yeah, and you look at the rushing yards. And, this is what I'm saying. I don't think they've started. I mean, that's nothing. Passing is really nothing. Turnovers, the Vikings had a turnover, but right here, four of those penalties against the Packers were really, two touchdowns.
Soda at their own 35. Two tight end setups. Cunningham takes it back to Smith. Let's swing it down to DJ Johnson on the sideline. I agree with what Ray Rose said.
I think 10-10, they've both been in a sparring match.
On third down, Cunningham lays it outside to David Palmer. And the pass is complete for a Viking first down.
Come up and hit Randy Moss. He goes right off him.
Smith. Into Packer territory, tripped up by George Koontz.
Maybe Denny Green meant that he wants to run more up the middle. He could take whatever happened to come in there.
Third and four. Moss comes in motion, walks in motion. Outside, not enough for a first down to Jake Reed. He hooked up too soon, and now they're going to mark it up close.
A pass or a quarterback sneak.
But you don't go at Gilbert Brown. Long count, Cunningham, and he did go at Gilbert Brown and went right by him.
Yeah, that's what he was doing. See, he was reading that. He figured if he keeps all his guys in, it's a hard to read. But by going and
Cunningham to Carter's first down Viking. Robert Smith inside the five, fighting down to about the three. Board. Nothing. The Packers come out of there with the ball, but it had been blown dead. Moss stood out wide to the right. They walked it in that direction, and Moss makes the catch, touchdown. He might have pushed a little bit and then outjumped everybody. They're saying he was juggling, no good. Exactly right. Watch him push.
Well, they didn't call the push. What they said is that he didn't have control, that he was juggling when he went out of bounds.
Yes, he was.
That he never did have control of the ball.
He never did have it. That's exactly right.
Now, again, the boundaries are reviewable. If the official said that he was juggling and didn't have control, that is not a reviewable play under instant replay.
If you have it between your legs, is that control?
Yeah, that is.
This was that he was juggling the ball.
That's what he said. So then that makes it non-reviewable. So they are, in essence, reviewing a non-reviewable play. Now, at any point, does he have control
now,
of the
right
ball?
There, maybe?
Yeah.
Play on the field stance is called. The player never had. possession of the ball. Incomplete pass. That's a charge timeout, Minnesota.
They charge him a timeout. They did review the play. He never had control.
It didn't help him anyway.
Cunningham moves Leroy hard. This is Carter in motion. And Cunningham back to throw and lost it again to Moss. And again, he had one hand on it and lost it. That one won't be reviewed. He never had it.
But that's not a bad weapon. I mean, at least they're attacking down here. I mean, I think when you have a guy like Randy Moss, I think that's what you have to do. And Randy Moss, you know, just got that hand. He's bringing it in and didn't come down with it.
Came down with air. So Gary Anderson with Berger holding.
If they took two shots down there that kind of reminded you of the Minnesota Vikings of last year. They only lost one game all year.
This will be from 22 yards out. He's had a couple blocked already this year, but this one's good. And the Vikings recapture the lead. 13-10. With 9:17 left in the third.
Kinds of things.
But it's come to that in a lot of cases.
Bacon's bad.
Evans out of the backfield. They drop it up the middle to Antonio Freeman, and that'll be enough for a Green Bay first down. By the way, congratulations to Antonio Freeman, and congratulations to our Ryder Cup team as well, as they came from behind to win it for the United States.
And he hit the hole between them.
Levin hit the hole quick and bang for his longest game from scrimmage of the day.
Still didn't bang to that yellow line to stop the Green Bay Packers.
Levin gets the first down. Well disguised by the Packers and Favre and Levin. Jimmy Hitchcock tripped him up.
You know, we said that Dorsey Levins does get stronger as the game goes on, and you would...
That's Levins in motion. Back to Henderson. Favre gets it to William Henderson. And Henderson stumbles across midfield into Viking territory. John Randall. Favre drops the throw. Gets it across the middle. Antonio Freeman down to the Viking 35, stopped by Robert Griffith. Three wide receivers set up for Favre in Green Bay this time, and he drops the throw. Protection's not bad, wide open. There's Antonio, I beg your pardon, Corey Bradford. And Bradford.
Let's see what the Packers are doing now, is they're running two or three wide receivers deep. The guy coming underneath.
What a good shot that was.
And Brett Favre helped that by looking deep.
Levin gets the first down, gets across the 25, and the Vikings continue to try to push him back. The crowd.
Football hook shot.
First down, Green Bay, two tight ends. Levin's on the toss back. The old counter toss. Out of bounds at about the 17-yard line.
There's
Orlando Thomas.
There's that play that Oakland hurt Minnesota with. The kicker is the guy that starts thinking on this down.
Third and four. Incomplete and no flag. Intended for Schrader. Believes me. Knows when his time has come.
Yeah, and the field goal team should do. We want confidence. Your offense is going to get a first down.
Longwell is good. Again, from 35 yards, the score is tied 13 apiece. Jimbo Field will continue after a word from your local Fox station.
Red 79, blue 18, hot, hot!
Maybe come down a little darker.
How much can you know about yourself if you've never been in a fight?
From the director of Seven.
The first rule of Fight Club is do not talk about Fight Club.
We gotta take Fight Club up a notch.
What did you guys do?
Without paying, you would have nothing.
What kind of sick game are you playing?
Brad Pitt.
We're not killing anyone, man.
We're setting them free.
It's too much.
Edward Norton.
Something terrible is about to happen.
What did you expect?
Fight Club. Rated R.
October 15th, only in theaters.
Yeah. DJ, 170 million. That's a record. Think it's going to change you?
Absolutely not. DJ Tucker's never been about money. EJ Tucker's never played for money, and money will not change EJ Tucker, not one iota.
Say, is that a Bud Light?
Oh, yeah, it's last one.
Oh, yeah? What do you say I give you $1 million for?
With a great taste that won't fill you up and never let you down, make it a Bud Light.
What do you want for that watch?
Welcome to Football Fantasy. Let's meet today's contestant, Chip. It's time to meet your players.
Hey, Chip.
Hey, Chippy.
Hey there, Chip, buddy.
Okay, Chip, you've got the ball.
Player number one,
what's your idea of fun on a Sunday afternoon?
Wow, that's tough.
I'm going to tote the rock for 300 yards and 5 touchdowns.
Number two?
I'm going to throw for 400 and 6 touchdowns. Just for you, Chip.
Ooh, yeah.
Hey, number three.
I'm going to order pizza with extra cheese for me and my pal Chip.
Yeah!
Funny.
Player number two, here we go.
Oh, time's up.
I can't decide.
You don't have to. You get NFL Sunday Ticket only on DirecTV. You get to choose the games and players you want to watch all regular season long.
DirecTV, what are you looking at? Now get 3 months of programming free when you get DirecTV.
He isn't playing him like a linebacker, though.
He hasn't caught a pass. He goes in motion. Stays in the block, and he checks out. Oh, gets it out to Levins, and Levins breaks a couple of tackles and gets a first down.
Take a hole for himself when he watches film.
Levins gets stronger as the game goes by. He got a first down for the Packers. Levins needs to get stronger, and he does. Dorsey Levins, a flag on the play. He got about 9 on that run.
He's just complaining about
holding. 62, offense.
That's exactly.
Still first down. Yep.
That's exactly who it was. The right guard, Marco
Rappaport. Right. First and 20. Davis goes in motion. Favre drops the throw. Up the middle to Bradford, and Bradford gets back to about the 39-yard line, still short of a first down by a couple. But Corey Bradford. Levins is stepping out of bounds after he gets the first down, pushed out by Dwayne Rudd.
That's a gun, too.
Here's Favre, takes to Levins. Fires up the field, and that should be Antonio Freeman, and is the first down. Range yet. They need about another first down. Favre drops the throw. Has some time, and he's going to take off this time. Brett Favre chased, and down he goes. Flag on the play. Dwayne Rudd, who can really run.
Yeah, Dwayne Rudd looked
but
like
he's
he
down.
Hurt his left hip.
Yep.
Illegal contact. Number 24, defense. You're penalized 5 yards.
Robert Griffin.
That's the first down.
That was over here on the other side of the field.
Automatic first down. Here's Favre to throw it. Quick to Levins, one-handed catch. He cuts back inside. Dorsey Levins inside the 20. First down, Green Bay.
Down.
They need 7. He has to have some time, too, and he tried to throw the screen pass, but he was rushed and hurried. Intended for Levins, who didn't have a chance to turn around. Here comes the field goal unit. He's hit 2. He's hit 3. The Packers take the lead 16-13. Ray Rhodes.
And now they have to go to their defense. And now,
second and long. Cunningham drops some throws and passes complete. And off to the races is Jake Reed, chased. Jake Reed all the way down to the Packer 25, finally caught by Fred Benson. One of those 3 draft choices.
Yep, and they got the other one first. The other one is Antoine Edwards. And you're going to see Edwards here. And they start in the slant right here. He comes up and he misses the tackle. So that was, you're talking about, here's the second rookie who's going to make the play. The first one that gave him that play was Antoine Edwards.
50 yards. Yes. 3.5 minutes left. Cunningham gives to Smith. Robert Smith. still running down close to the 20. About three. Cunningham hands again to Smith, and Smith breaks inside the 10 to about the 9.5 yard line. Green Bay leads at 16-13. For those of you who just joined us, we have 2.5 minutes left to play at Lambeau Field. Randy Moss has only caught one pass, gained 3 yards. Green Bay only one touchdown scored, that by the defensive unit.
But with a Brett Favre quarterback team, you don't want to score too soon, but you can't let that do anything to you.
Cunningham trying to score and does to Randy Moss. And that gives Green Bay a minute and 56 seconds when they get the ball back.
We were talking about Randy Moss was frustrated. He was frustrated, but he didn't let it keep from stopping doing that. It was eventually, I mean, you just keep going all day. He only catches one ball. And then you need a touchdown. You're behind by three. And just watch him. Here he's in the slot. He gets by Darren Sharper. He gets inside right there and just settles down.
Yep.
The Packers were running the zone, and he just got inside and settled down. And Randall Cunningham hit him.
Extra point is good by Anderson. And it's the Vikings 20. The offensive line faces a big challenge here as well. Bard standing in the pocket. Chased by Randall, throws deep. Complete. Corey Bradford came up with it.
I don't care. No one else in football can make that play but Brett Favre. They said he doesn't throw as well when he runs to his left. Huddle here. Everything is done out of audible.
Didn't spike it. Drops it off to Levins, and Levins takes his feet. He stays on his feet to the 45. I don't know how he struggled for a first down.
Dante DiTrappio. Sam was Randy's coach in Midget League. How do you think Randy's doing in the NFL?
I think he's doing great. I think he's the best in the West.
Best in the West? Or best in the world?
Best in the world.
Best in the world, huh? You brought him up. You taught him everything you know?
I tried to. It's on him.
All right, back to you, Pat and John.
First and 10, Green Bay. Barb again drops. Barb has time. 11 to the 30 and out of bounds.
Well, you said earlier, Pat, that the offensive line has to do its job, and they all bounced out. So the ground can't cause a fumble, but he didn't have control of it.
On second down, Barb. Bill Schrader.
That brings up third. Yeah, and he can't spike it here either.
Technical producer Bob Mueller. Pre-game show is produced by Scott Ackerson, directed by Bob Levy. The senior producer is Bill Brown. The team that wins it's going to be tied for the lead in the NFC Central for a week at least. And here's Favre. Outside level. And he couldn't get out of bounds. Can't stop the clock.
And can't get a first down.
So they got to hurry. Hitchcock.
If he could have gotten a first down, then they could have spiked it. But because they didn't get a first down, he can't spike it because it's fourth down. He should have thrown that ball beyond the first down mark.
And they got to hurry now.
And he can't spike it. He needs a first down.
He knows that. Touchdown, Green Bay.
Unbelievable.
Five to Bradford. We got a look at how he got that open and how far it hit him.
And it had to be an audible because they didn't have any timeouts. It was fourth down. He had to call the play on the line of scrimmage. You can just see Bradford right there. He just runs right by him.
Right by Hitchcock. And right into the stand.
I think Jimmy Hitchcock was waiting for a shorter pattern. I think Jimmy Hitchcock was playing something shorter, and he was trying to get underneath of Bradford.
Well, if you can pump fake. There it is.
There's a pump fake to the right, and then he comes back. And I think Jimmy Hitchcock was trying to undercut that, trying to run underneath it, thinking it was going to be a shorter pattern, and Brett Favre just threw it perfectly right over him to Corey Bradford.
Green Bay 23-20 over Minnesota.
And that's Favre down.
Exhausted.
And remember the Oakland game. Whew.
He has every right to be exhausted. He was so aware of what was going on. As you pointed out, he couldn't spike it. He had to run a play. They had to get a first down or a touchdown, which they got. 6 out of 7 for 77 yards in that drive. And 12 seconds are left. He's getting oxygen on the sideline. He's okay, I think.
And we need to say that not one person is left, and I think some have come in.
Cunningham going deep. Bouncing around is the ball, and the Packers come down with it. The interception by Antoine Edwards, and Brett Favre is sitting up on the sideline, but he is flat exhausted.
I think he's more than exhausted. I mean, Randall Cunningham did what he had to do. He moved his team down and got that score. I mentioned that maybe, you know, the dilemma is you don't want to score too soon. They did, but Randall Cunningham and the Vikings did what they had to offensively.
They got the touchdown quick.
It was just that they were up against Brett Favre.
But how do you do? What do you do? You want to get ahead on the scoreboard. You don't want to give Favre a chance, but you got to get the touchdown. And a chance is all he needs.
He's a real warrior.
Let's go down to DJ Johnson.
Great touchdown into the game. How's it feel to end a Packer-Viking game like that?
Feel great. This is my dream come true. Plus, we have to get them back for what they did to us last year when we came here.
Is this sort of redemption for you guys?
Yeah, feel great.
How'd it feel when Randy Moss scored that last touchdown? Did you guys think it was over?
We didn't really think it was over because, you know, Brett is the comeback king. So as long as, you know, he had a chance to score, we know we was going to score.
What did you see the cornerback do to make you know you can get by him?
As soon as I started, he jumped it outside. I just, you know, adjusted and kind of seen hope.
Okay, thanks, and congratulations. All right, back to you, Pat and John.
All right, DJ, and we'll be right back in a moment. Brett Favre headed for the locker room.